John MacArthur's ministry has had an impact on both me and my wife Kathy in ways that neither one of us could adequately put into words. And I think the argument can be made. I've said this before and some people don't like it, but I'll say it again because I believe it. I think the argument can be made that given the sheer size, the sheer scope of John MacArthur's ministry and all that goes along with it, that God has used him in a greater way than any other single individual since the apostolic era.
Beautiful! Have you guys heard this one?
I know a man.
I'm hopelessly devoted to you.
Teaching so quickly, at the click of a button, you know, teaching can go out all around the world. When you look at the Master Seminary and all of the, who knows how many men, thousands of men that they have trained to be expositors of Scripture, to be pastors, how to shepherd a church, and these men have gone out all over the world. So I think God has used, in His providence, has chosen to use John MacArthur in a greater way than any other single individual in the apostolic era.
You must unlearn what you have learned.
All right, I'll give it a try.
No! Try not! Do! Or do not. There is no try.
Well, let me just solve this thing. Let's forget all that and just put one word in there. Whosoever. Amen. Whosoever. That's better than anybody's name spelled out. Who are the elect? I can settle that in 30 seconds. The elect or the whosoever wills. You want to be saved? Come on. Hallelujah. Glory to God. You want to be saved? Come to Jesus. And He's reaching out His nail-pierced hands to you and saying, come. Come, come. Jesus says come. The Spirit says come. The bride says come. The individual says come. You can come and drink.